So in this video, children, we are going to study about the other contraceptive methods. One is the intrauterine device. Okay, so the next one is intrauterine device. As the name suggests, it means we are going to insert something into the uterus to block the passage of sperms, and we will not allow the fertilization to occur. Now, these intrauterine devices or IUDs, these are inserted by doctors or nurses in the uterus through vagina. They increase phagocytosis of sperms. Phagocytosis means the sperms will be engulfed and destroyed. So this is how the contraception will be done and the fertilization will be prevented. IUDs are ideal method to delay the pregnancy or space children, that is if already the couple has one child, so they want to plan the next one after 3 to 4 years, so they can use the IUDs. Now there are various types of IUDs: non-medicated IUDs, copper releasing IUDs, and hormone releasing IUDs. So let's move on and see them in detail. Non-medicated IUDs, children, they are related, they retard the sperm motility. That is, the movement of sperm is being blocked, or the movement is being retarded by using these IUDs. Also have spermicidal effect. Not only they will retard the motility or the movement, they will also kill the sperms. Examples given are lips loop, as you see in the figure shown. Then we come to the copper releasing IUDs. Copper ions are the ones which suppress the motility, that is they will retard again the movement and fertilization capacity of the sperms. Examples are copper T, copper 7, multi-load 375. These are the various examples you can see there in the diagram. These are the IUDs which are inserted into the female genital tract, and this will retard the motility of the sperm and also the fertilizing capacity. Next ones are the hormone releasing IUDs. They make the uterus unsuitable for the implantation and the cervix hostile to the sperms. So as we know, the sperms are moving on and passing through the cervix, so they will make the cervix hostile, and that means the sperms, even if they go there, they will be destroyed. And they are also making the uterus unsuitable for implantation. Suppose if the fertilization has occurred, then it will not allow the implantation procedure and hence no pregnancy. So they are actually hormone releasing. So which hormone are they using? Progesterone and LNG20. These are the hormone released during the use of these IUDs in the female genital tract. Okay, next is, children, oral contraceptives. These are the pills used by the female. Oral administration of progestogens or progestogen estrogen combinations in the form of tablets or pills. Now these pills are taken daily. The packet or the pills, they are written within days, like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. So every day the lady has to take a pill for 21 days starting within the first 5 period of menstruation cycle. Now suppose she has started the menstruation on 1st of January, so she can start taking these pills on 3rd Jan or 4th Jan, and after she will take these pills for 21 days starting from the menstrual cycle, starting from within the menstrual cycle. She can take the pills from 2nd day of her menstrual cycle or 3rd day of her menstrual cycle, and from that day till 21 days she will take these pills. Then after a gap of 7 days, which is her next menstrual period, it should be repeated in the same till the female desires to prevent conception. till she is ready. Now suppose she has made up her mind that she want to have the conception, then she will stop taking the pills. Now what do the pills do? They inhibit ovulation, and if there is no ovulation, no egg or ovum, so no fertilization. And even if the ovulation has occurred, there will be no implantation and thickening of cervical mucus, and the cervix mucus is so thick that it will prevent the entry of sperms to reach the ovum. So see, they are actually doing three ways of not allowing the sperm and ovum to meet. One is the ovulation. If ovulation is, suppose ovulation is done, then no implantation. And they are also trying to prevent the entry of sperm. So pills are very effective and with lesser side effects. Now there is a very good contraceptive, oral contraceptive given to us by the Indian government. New oral contraceptive for females is Saheli. It is developed by Central Drug Research Institute in Lucknow. It contains a non-steroidal preparation. No steroids are present here. It is once a week. Now, every day taking a pill was a tedious job for the ladies, because you may skip one of the days for any of the reason. So now what they have done is they have given a pill which is once a week and with very few side effects, and the contraceptive value is very high. So this is a very good contraceptive, oral contraceptive, very easy, only one pill once a week. So it's quite easy. Next is injectables. Now progestogens or progestogen estrogen combinations are used by females as injections or implants under the skin. This is the you see the area where they can implant it under the skin. You can see here. Their mode of action is like that of pills only, and their effective period are much longer. So in this case, they need not take a pill every week because they have implanted it. But the way of obstructing the pregnancy is same as that of pill, because they are filled with the same hormones, and the hormones will behave or act in the same manner as done by the oral contraceptive. So progestogen or progesterone estrogen combinations and IUDs are used as emergency contraceptives within 72 hours of coitus. It avoids pregnancy due to rape or casual intercourse. The eye pills that we see ads in the television, these are the progestogen or progestogen estrogen combinations. And if there is a rape or a casual intercourse and the couple was not aware of the situation, they can take, the female then can take these pills within 72 hours of the coitus to prevent the pregnancy. Last one is the surgical method. It helps to block gamete transport and thereby prevent conception. It is very effective, but reversibility is poor. Very negligible charges changes can be done. It cannot be reversed. There are two types of surgical methods. One is vasectomy, the other one is tubectomy. Now vasectomy is the, you see, sterilization procedure in males. In this, a small part of the vast difference, as you see in the diagram, is removed or tied up through a small incision. A cut is given and then all the two ends are tied up on the scrotum, as you see in the diagram. So this is sterilization of males. Now the sterilization of females can also be done by a small part, cutting the small part of fallopian tube and removed or tied up through a small incision in the abdomen or through the vagina. As you see here, fallopian tubes are cut and tied. So to block the passage. Now the even if the egg is traveling, even if the egg is traveling, it will stop here and it will not move on. But then reversibility of such contraceptive methods is very, very poor. Okay, right. Side effects of anti-natural contraceptive methods. Yes, nausea, abdominal pain, breakthrough bleeding. Sometimes it may occur that a lot of bleeding, the female is suffering with this issue of lot of bleeding. Irregular menstrual bleeding may also occur, and breast cancer. So these are the various contraceptive side effects which are anti-natural, because yes, we are using some kind of hormones for this.